In the preference tab MIDI devices, there are two main ray areas and a selection box area which contains the reset commands. The upper area concerns all MIDI devices that transmit a signal to Reaper. The lower one concerns all the MIDI devices Reaper sends a signal to. The reset commands in the selection box area tells Reaper which resets to resend to the devices and only have an effect on them. Each area has three columns. The first column indicates the name of the MIDI device. The second column indicates the status of the device, which can be not present, enabled, enabled for control, enabled but absent, disabled. The same indications are found in the second area. For each device, by right-clicking, you can change its settings. In Configure Input, the field device name shows the name of the device that is transmitted to Reaper. In the field Alias Name, you can write a different name, perhaps more intuitive for you. This name appears in the MIDI choice on each track. This checkbox enables the device to communicate with Reaper. This checkbox allows the device to send control messages and direct them to a specific channel that you choose through the drop-down menu. If you have no particular problems, leave it default. Here below is the area for advanced MIDI events. Different timestamp modes can be selected, useful when you need to use a control surface, for example. As specified here, if the accuracy of the driver is not known, select the first option, which is the default. Always with the right button, you can configure all the parameters such as the input ID. Usually leave the default, but if you have conflict problems, now you know that you can do something here. When you no longer use the device, to make the ID and the reserved channel back available, right-click Forget Device, and it's permanently forgotten by Reaper. When the device is installed, right-click and enable it by Enable Input. If it's a control surface, also click on Enable Input for Control Messages. Right-click Control Messages Set Channel to assign a fixed communication channel. The operations seen above for the inputs are also available for the outputs, with the same meanings. However, there are also differences here, such as ability to send the clock to the MIDI device via Send Clock to Output. Or also select the Low Latency option, which, on the other hand, decreases accuracy. In addition, in Configure MIDI Output, you may want to send the clock to the device. Whether or not to send Sound Position Pointer, open the device in low latency and determine an offset if necessary. You can assign a MIDI joystick by clicking on this button. The device and the processing script are then selected. I don't have one, but in case you have one, use this option to set it appropriately. When Reaper is running and you forget to connect a keyboard, for example, you normally have to connect it to the MIDI socket and restart Reaper to show it to it. Using this button, you can instead show it to Reaper without restarting it. Through the Reset MIDI Devices section, it is possible to assign a button on the control bar that performs the same operation. In my opinion, it is more practical. Consider supporting the channel by becoming Patreon or pay me a beer or, listen to me, do what you want. Below the links in the description. That's it for the moment. Thanks for watching.